This video is sponsored by Into the AM. Use my code KevinKoolx at checkout, you get an additional 10% off, but more on them later.
We have the first in-game look of the new core for Season 4 called Hazmat, as well as Husky Raid confirmed to be returning into Halo Infinite, and it's going to be needing some community help. And we do have a time frame on when we can expect Husky Raid to return, but you might not like the news. So if you want to know more, stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. And did you know that 59.7 of you guys are not subscribed to the channel? Well, if you want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo, Marathon, and other things going on within gaming, well, make sure you tap subscribe. Let's get right into the content. So blink and you'll miss it within this Dr. Squatch X Halo type of ad that we're getting right here. It showcases the Hazmat Core for Season 4. Hey, we just saw it. Did you see it right there? Let me bring it back for y'all. So here's a close-up shot of the Hazmat Core that we're getting for Season 4. This is not a Fracture Core. This is going to be the main Battle Pass Core that we're going to get. Honestly, it kind of looks like a mix between the Rakshasa Core and like a typical Mark 7, Mark 5 Core. So here's an image ripped from the Dr. Squatch website that actually showcases a full body picture of the in-game Hazmat Core, guys. And this is actually looking kind of cool. Like, I still like my Mark 7, Mark 5 and SPI armor probably a bit more, but this actually doesn't look too shabby. Like, this actually looks kind of cool. I would probably rock it as well. Like, definitely more interested in this type of core than I am with, say, like Chimera or the Eagle Strike or anything else. This core was first leaked out with this image right here. This is some in-game art that was ripped from the game files, I'm assuming, of Halo Infinite. And you can see how it's a different type of a helmet style, different types of armor pieces attached to it as well. So there's going to be some variations with this, obviously. I find it a little odd, though, that we have like a Hazmat Core, right? Like, definitely meant to be like biohazard kind of stuff, kind of based off of that kind of thing we see within real life. But the thing is that with Season 4 having infection, which was confirmed earlier on the channel here, that the AI infection doesn't really bother with like a true like biochemical safe suit like we have like with this Hazmat Core in a way. I mean, it looks cool. It's a nice addition to the customization that we already have within the game, a unique take on different types of Spartan armor as well. But I just feel like this type of armor would work really well if it was like a flood infection rather than an AI infection. But I'm still down with the AI infection thing. I think it's a cool idea as well. Now, the reason why I'm saying this is going to be like the Battle Pass main core, not a Fracture Core, even though this kind of seemed to fit much more in the Fracture style, because we're going to get Tenrai 2 for Season 4, get to build out more of that customization for your Yorai armor set. And of course, as we get closer to the release of Season 4, we'll get some more information and I'll share with you guys here on the channel.
Thanks to today's sponsor, Into the AM. Into the AM are a team of artists and creators who share a common vision. They see clothing as a canvas to express what drives you. Since 2012, they've developed premium apparel that elevates self-expression and provides unparalleled comfort for wherever your passions take you. Into the AM recently sent me some apparel to check out, and honestly guys, I'm really enjoying this stuff. I like the art style they put on the shirts, and I also got some cool joggers that go with it that fit me really well. If you're not into all the crazy styles, don't worry, they have some simple tees for you as well. They fit great, they feel great, and I genuinely do enjoy their products. If you use my code KevinKoolx, you receive an additional 10% off of your purchase. Plus, I get a little kickback and help support the channel as well. Into the AM has been a long time sponsor of the channel, and I genuinely do enjoy their products a lot. So guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you much Into the AM for sponsoring the video. So let's get right back into those details.
Now get ready to raid in Halo Infinite. Not that kind of raid you're thinking of, but more of a Husky Raid. The classic mode from Halo 4 got popularized within Halo 5 for sure. It's going to be coming back into Halo Infinite. They just stated this within a blog showcasing like what you're going to need to do to be able to play Husky Raid. But the cool thing is that this is going to be Forge created, community created maps for this upcoming playlist. And 343 actually provided two different templates, an alleyway template and a trench template when it comes to building out their Husky Raid map, so people can just art it up how they like. Though 343 did state that you can just kind of create whatever you want. These templates are really just kind of there, so if you want to just jump in and art it up, you can, but you can also just create your own thing as long as it works out well. If you want to get your map noticed, they said make sure to tag the map with the Ask343 Husky Raid tag within the game here. And make sure your map has been submitted by June 30th. That is the cutoff when it comes to getting your map hopefully put into matchmaking for Husky Raid. I'm excited about this because I love Husky Raid. It's just total chaos. It's just silly and stupid fun, which I think we need more of when it comes to Halo Infinite. It's so focused on that competitive multiplayer experience that we haven't really had a chance to really dive into more chaotic fun stuff. We have a little bit of that with like the Lone Wolves playlist, but that's about it. The Super Fiesta playlist option was awesome. I really enjoyed it as well, but again, it's kind of just Fiesta. I don't have a whole lot of fun with it. But when you put it on a map like Husky Raid, which is basically a long hallway with two flags at the end, and it's capture the flag with crazy weapons, and also hopefully get some campaign weapons and campaign variants of equipment thrown in there as well, now you're talking about a blast, literally. Now remember at the top of this video when I said you might not like the timing of when Husky Raid will return into Halo Infinite, because we have this previous bit of information when it comes to being Forge maps being put into Halo Infinite, showcasing here saying that the best turnaround that's seen is about an 8-week period of being found to eventually being put into matchmaking. Though there is a little bit of light at the end of that Husky Raid tunnel, and Michael Shore gives us a little bit of a glimpse in a reply on Twitter stating that given their simpler setup, it's possible that we could ingest Husky Raid maps quicker, but I'd still stick with the 2-month timeline, and given this ask, we might have more maps we want to add to the game, which would offset that time saving. So basically, we're looking at a 2-month period from the end of June to the soonest we could see Husky Raid come into Halo Infinite. But my assumption is that they'll probably save that until season 5. Given how season 4 is coming out on June 20th, it makes me think that probably around the end of October, early November is when we will see season 5 release. Most likely with a whole bunch of maps though, hopefully, for Husky Raid. There also have been tons of leaks when it comes to content coming into the future of Halo Infinite, new maps and modes that are developer made as well. So this is gonna be an additional bit of content helped by the community to be created, to be put into Halo Infinite, while 343 is also polishing up the maps that they already have planned for like BTB and Arena. Now we cover a lot of things about Halo on this channel, all the way from current day until the very first one that Bungie created back in 2001. But Bungie just announced that they're making a new game, and it's called Marathon. And I made a video talking all about it on this video right here about like an ARG that they're doing, which is akin to like I Love Bees. Some really cool stuff. Check out that video, guys. Thank you all for watching. Catch you on the next one. Peace out.